This is an overview of an article entitled Yield of the RYR2 Genetic Test in Suspected Catecholaminergic Polymorphic Ventricular Tachycardia and Implications for Test Interpretation, published in the February 2018 issue of Circulation, Genomic and Precision Medicine. Catecholaminergic Polymorphic Ventricular Tachycardia, or CPVT, is an inherited arrhythmia condition estimated to affect 1 in 10,000 individuals. Classically, CPVT manifests as exercise or emotional stress induced bidirectional or polymorphic ventricular tachycardia, leading to syncope, seizures, or sudden cardiac death in the setting of a structurally normal heart, with reported mortality rates as high as 30% to 50% by age 35 years. Early identification of those at risk for this potentially lethal disorder is critical. Pathogenic variants in the cardiac ryanodine receptor gene, or RYR2, are responsible for approximately 60% of clinically definite CPVT cases. While the discovery of CPVT mutation hotspots originally led to targeted genetic screening, recent advances in sequencing technology have now enabled cost-effective screening of RYR2's 105 total coding exons. The RYR2 genetic test for CPVT is considered to be one of the most robust cardiac genetic tests, resulting in consensus guidelines recommending genetic testing for any patient in whom a cardiologist clinically suspects CPVT, along with subsequent cascade screening in family members. Indeed, CPVT is considered to be diagnosed in patients who have a pathogenic mutation in RYR2. Of note, data from exome sequence collections, such as that of the Exome Aggregation Consortium, or EXAC, indicate that approximately 3% of ostensibly healthy individuals carry a rare protein-altering variant in RYR2. This complicates the diagnosis of CPVT on the basis of genetic test results, and raises the question of how to best manage the patient and family members with the finding of a novel rare variant in RYR2. In the paper under discussion, the authors considered three groups of patients who had undergone RYR2 genetic testing. First, a total of 1,200 unrelated and suspected CPVT patients who were referred by providers for RYR2 genetic testing between 2009 and 2014. Second, 78 well-phenotype patients who were evaluated and assessed by the authors and classified as strong CPVT on the basis of having a history of exertional syncope with documentation of exercise-related bidirectional or polymorphic ventricular tachycardia. Third, 77 patients who were evaluated and assessed by the authors and classified as possible CPVT on the basis of having a history of exertional syncope and stress test-induced ventricular ectopy or exercise-induced cardiac events and a QTC interval less than or equal to 480 milliseconds. This graph shows the yield of RYR2 genetic testing in the first group, the patient referrals, stratified by age. The proportion of patients who were positive for a rare RYR2 variant was substantially higher in younger patients. This is not surprising given the high mortality of CPVT at a younger age. This graph shows the yield of RYR2 genetic testing in all three patient groups. The yield was highest in the well-phenotyped strong CPVT cases, intermediate in the well-phenotyped possible CPVT cases, and lowest in the referred patients. For the strong cases and possible cases, the proportion of the variants that were pathogenic was estimated by comparing the variants against those found in the ostensibly healthy people represented in EXAC, which are presumably benign and indicated here with the red dotted line as a background level of RYR2 rare variants in the general population. These estimates are indicated in the white boxes in the midst of the bars in the graph. This graph shows the data after RYR2 rare variants that were seen in multiple patients were removed from the data. In other words, only variants that were unique to individual patients are represented here. For the purposes of this study, these variants were considered to be new or novel. There are still significant discrepancies in the yields among the three patient groups. The estimated pathogenicity of variants is again shown in the white boxes in the bars. What's notable is that in strong CPVT cases, there are an estimated 1 in 10 false positive new variants. In other words, for a patient who's felt by clinical criteria to have CPVT and then undergoes RYR2 genetic testing, if a new variant is found, there's a 1 in 10 chance that it's not pathogenic for CPVT. The false positive rate is even higher for possible CPVT cases, 1 in 5. This argues against the practice of automatically considering a finding of a novel RYR2 rare variant in a patient to be diagnostic of CPVT. This graph shows the distributions of RYR2 rare variants across the gene's 105 exons in the well-phenotyped patients, the referred patients, and the ostensibly healthy people in EXAC. The previously defined mutation hotspots in the gene are indicated by the black bars at the top of the graph. Whereas the EXAC variants are fairly evenly distributed across the exons, the variants in the patient groups mostly cluster in exons within the hotspots. The patient variants are enriched in 21 exons in the gene compared to EXAC variants, suggesting that variants in any of the 21 exons are the most likely to be pathogenic. What are the clinical implications of this study? First, the greatly reduced yield of RYR2 genetic testing in referrals versus well-phenotyped patients suggests many referrals with a low pretest probability of CPVT. Second, in light of current consensus recommendations that RYR2 genetic testing be used to diagnose CPVT, there's the potential for many false positive diagnoses. Third, RYR2 rare variants outside of 21 hotspot exons are much more likely to be false positives. Finally, together, these findings reinforce the notion that careful clinical phenotyping of patients and careful genetic test interpretation are warranted by providers, which of course is true of all cardiovascular genetic disorders.